Hello everyone, welcome to the Reaper Podcast. I am your host, The Reaper. So, let's get into it. Now, we're doing this little short today in like sections because basically I've had some personal things to deal with. Give me 1 second. Alright, I'm back. There's a lot to be going on with. First of all, we're going to talk a little bit about... And, oh, by the way, except for Zach that's coming from Wacko Zach Apocus, we are going to have ABO from Spirited ABO, YouTube, Twitter, whatnot. We're going to have him on here as well. And we're going to be doing a lot of chatting with different stuff. We're going to be talking about the special Bleach surprise. I've been teasing Zach with the... He's on chapter 100 and something. Probably beyond that by now. I just read the last chapter, so I've been teasing him about it. He's very wary of me now because he thinks I'm going to tease him about it, which... I might. I hope you don't hear this. But anyway. Ooh, shots fired. There's just a lot of stuff going on, especially with the Death Stranding, I don't know how to pronounce his name. The bad guy, I know him for the bad guy from Casino Royale. From Bond, and he's supposed to be in Death Stranding, the picture that everybody got, and everybody's like, oh, it's a rumor now that he's, because of several things. We're going to be talking about that. We're going to be talking about a lot of shit. Oh, shit. And video game related or whatnot, we're going to be talking about it, and it's going to be fucking epic and awesome. Sorry for that. I do want to say thank you to... There's this thing going around that we made, and we're going to be talking about his ass video. Not his ass, but his ass. Just send me a better clip, which I'll be watching it. But this whole video game thing, this whole anime thing is just totally awesome. What's chat to? Zach said he's in chapter 169, and he's like, yeah, I'm listening, so yeah, we're gonna be talking about shit. I have not seen the newest Dragon Ball Supers episode, so, we'll be talking about a little bit about the stuff. The studio is actually going great. I'm actually on my new PC in my studio. So if you guys can hear a fan running, that's just to keep it cool, keep the airflow. And if you guys hear like an echo, I don't have shit entirely stable. Not stable, but I don't have like foam. So it's going to echo a little bit. But it's like total mess. So I'm just trying to get this out because I'm going to leave soon, but I'll be back. With Zach and ABO. Zach, if you're listening, I'm running out of time here, so I'm just going to finish this first part up, and I will be back after I get my father. To let you guys know, my father didn't have any breaks yesterday. So he took... What the hell? Okay, I'm going to ignore your call, Zach, or whoever. Just 1 second, man. But, he don't have any brakes. So he took the truck into the shop, and I have to go pick him up. So, it won't take that long. 15 minutes there, 15 minutes back. So, yeah. But a lot of cool stuff is going to come out today on the podcast. We're going to have a lot of laughs and funs and shit. And apparently, Spirited ABO is going to come out with something to... antagonize me with. The hell? Yes, I know. What? Zach is sending. What? I don't understand. Yes, you sent me that. What? Anyway, there's going to be a lot going on. We're going to have a great time on this podcast, and you'll see why in a minute. So, yeah. I'm trying to hurry. I'm trying to think. I don't do a good under... Me do not good under pressure. So, yeah. Fuck. There's a lot of shit I forgot. I know it. But we're just going to be talking about random shit. Let's put it that way. Anime, video games, Haido, Konami, Death Stranding, ass. A lot of ass we're going to be talking about. So yeah. So I'm out of time. I have to go. And when I come back, I'll have Zach and Spirited Debbio. So I'm going to take like, you know, maybe a 25 minute break. And I'll be coming back. See you guys. This is the Reaper here, back. Sorry it took so long, but I am here with Zach from Wacko Zacka Podcast.
Ooh. What up, guys?
And ABO, Spirit from Spirited ABO.
What's up?
So, today there's a lot of shit talking about, and ABO has some news to start off.
Oh, I got something that will trigger Nico really well. Are you ready for this?
600.
Oh, no. Nothing to do with that. It actually involves Death Note.
Oh, yeah.
Netflix is bringing out a brand new series, and one of their cast choices was that they made L, the person who plays L. They casted a African-American to play L.
Oh, I'm triggered! I don't care.
I thought you would be like one of those guys who's just like, it has to follow the same premise as everything. It has to be perfect. I thought you'd be one of those.
No. Really, it's interesting to see a new spin on it, especially because this is going to be a Netflix original. I've been hearing about this for a little while now. Like, I've been following this since, I think, what is it? Like, December of 2015, like when they first announced it. It was originally going to be a movie, like an American film, but then it turned into whatever this is.
Sorry, I had to move my mic down so I can sit down.
Tell them the other news.
What's the other news?
I forget. What was it again? You say it.
Okay. They changed Light's name.
Oh, yeah. I got this. They changed Light Yagami's last name. Guess what his last name is?
What is his last name?
Light Turner.
What the? Okay, no, see, now that's not okay.
Yeah, it's a reaction.
That's not okay.
What?
That's stupid.
You don't want Light Turner writing your name in the Death Note.
They want Light Turner. Ugh. Something fucking William Turner from Pirates of the Caribbean.
I was thinking of like Timmy Turner. When
Bucktooth Nerd.
Fair League Death Parents.
Timmy Turner gets a Death Note, kills everyone.
Yep. All CGI animated, like the movie.
I wish for a Death Note.
Oh, what? A Death Note. It's like he's turning into his goth teens. He's just like, I want a Death Note. I want to write people's names in my death note.
Are you happy?
God.
No.
That's hilarious. But anyways, yeah, that's stupid, but I'm interested to see where this goes. I mean, they can't do any worse than the J drama.
This is America,
they can.
My
friend. The first movie, they can. That first movie sucked ass.
Oh, fuck you. Okay, so let's get into another topic, because I can... Oh, god damn it.
Nico, listen, man. They're trying to Americanize an anime. They have done this before, and it became shit. I have to remind you of Dragon Ball Evolution?
I just thought the exact same thing. Oh, no.
Yeah, they're Americanized.
They might, they might have a different kind of setup team, though. They might actually have some, like, people who know the culture.
Well, it don't really matter, because you gotta follow the story. Like, Dragon Ball, the whole thing was about the Monkey King lore. That's
you know, we're talking about this. You know what we're doing? This is the Ghostbuster effect. We're talking shit about this thing we haven't even seen yet. So
I don't hold any opinions to it. I just think Late Turner is a stupid ass name.
It is. But anyways, I reserve my judgment on the actual thing until I see it.
I do too. But once
I'm not
I saw
going
the
to
trailer...
use Dragon Ball Evolution. I'm not going to use Dragon Ball Evolution, which is a shitty B film. I'm not going to use that as a measuring stick for any Japanese anime, like, you know, like what is it? Like any animated like anime live action movie.
But see, that's the thing. When you take the Japanese culture of the whole fucking the reason why the series is based on, if you take that fucking out and put Americanize it, dude, it's shit.
Yeah.
What the hell are you saying, ABO?
Don't worry about it. I'm whispering things to the audience.
Subliminal messaging.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
I was just whispering while you guys were talking. I was just like, SAO sucks. I wanted you to look back at it and just hear it and just go, what the fuck?
But the thing is, Ghostbusters, dude, as soon as I saw the trailer, I knew it was shit.
Oh, yeah. I think everyone knew it was shit.
Yeah. I mean, they lost $70 million.
Feminist agenda, that's all it was.
Well, have you watched Angry Joe's review about it?
I saw a bit of it, yeah.
I mean, like you said, dude, it was sexist and racist. I mean, it was just... It was all in one, and the first joke of the damn movie was a queef joke.
God damn it.
Yeah.
Queef. Sorry, too much subliminal messages?
Queef.
It's like that episode of South Park, the queefing, it's Eat, Pray, Queef. Like, that episode is beautiful.
Eat, Pray, Queef.
Like, have you guys seen that one?
Sounds familiar.
No.
Terrence and Phillip, their two-parter was cut off, and in its place is a new show in which there's a Terrence and Phillip female cast, and they're, instead of farting, they're queefing, and all the men get extremely offended by it, and they're like, why can't women queef? You know, that's the exact same thing as farting.
Jeez.
It was fucking hilarious. Pretty much any episode with what's his name in it? Randy? Any episode with Randy in it is awesome.
Dude, Randy, oh my god, dude, he is funny as shit.
I love that one where he's got cancer in his balls.
Oh god, that one. Wagon. God damn it.
I like some fisherman's friend and some of your best California Kush. Jesus Christ, Randy! I know, smoking a joint in front of a cop. Oh yeah.
I like the one where the internet goes out.
Messages.
Oh, yeah, it was a ghost. It was a spooky ghost. It's ectoplasm.
And he's like, ah. Alrighty. Now,
let's talk about the announcement.
Announcement?
Bleach.
Oh, the special announcement. Okay. Me and Nico talked about it, but at the end of the fucking chapter, the end of Bleach, quote unquote, supposedly, not gonna ruin any spoilers. Anyway, at the end of it, the special announcement was that they are making a live action movie of Bleach. Which, nice. I think, believe, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it's going to be in the same direction as the Attack on Titan live action.
I doubt it, because the person who announced it was Taikubo, if I'm not mistaken, right?
I think so.
So, I mean, I mentioned this earlier, is that if it's done right, if it's done under the direction of the original creator, then they can make... What the fuck was that?
What was what?
What? There's some... I heard, like, fucking guitar.
I think you're hearing shit.
Okay, whatever. Anyways, like I was saying,
hang on,
though,
hang
is...
Hang on, wait. Let me try something.
Yeah, it's... AVO just had a fucking guitar.
No, I didn't.
I heard, like, a... Ding, 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 ding.
I think your headset is fucked.
Okay, no, I heard the sound, it can't... I looked over, and your fucking thing was going blue. Which means there was sound coming from you.
Maybe do
I
you...
was breathing really hard. I had Cheetos, alright?
Okay, whatever.
You're judging me.
Anyways, so what I was saying, though, is that if they do this right, if they do this thing right, that, it could be good. If it's under the right direction of the original, like, creator, like, if Taikubo is running the production of the film, they can do it right. You know, there's a controversial topic on the Death Note series. However, I think they did it right in a cinematic form. Like, if you take any fucking, you know, like, example, comic book movies, like the DC universe, the cinematic universe, or the Marvel DC, you know, the Marvel cinematic universe, they're all completely different from the comics. And I think the thing... Oh, shut the
sorry.
Fuck up.
Fine.
What?
Nothing. I was just... No, don't worry about it, dude. All right? Don't worry about it.
Okay. I won't worry about it.
All right.
What I'm saying, though, is that you look at those and you compare them to their source material. Of course, they fuck it up. They change things. Like, I saw the Civil War, and that film, like, the Civil War, it has nothing. It's like the Avengers trying to reenact the Civil War. It wasn't. I'm gonna quote Ark Noble. It wasn't. That wasn't a civil war. That was a fight in the airport parking lot. And see, I think the thing is, you can look back. You can look at that, and then now you look over at the Death Note movie, and you can see a lot of the same type of things in a cinematic universe. Yes, of course they're not gonna be able to put all of the shit that happens in Death Note into two films. However, they have to spin it in what way they can to make it into a movie that people who haven't seen the anime can enjoy and intake.
But here's my opinion for... I know this is going to trigger you, but for the first Death Note series, was there, like, not for the series, but for the first movie, was there a reason why they had to get a over-sweaty guy in an overcoat to play Kira in the entire movie?
What?
Because the one that I watched was probably a lot different than yours, because I remember watching it, and there was, like, a fucking... It looked like a guy who was, like, sweating all the time. Like, he wore no shirt with an overcoat, and that was Light Yagami.
No, that is not the fucking movie I watched.
That was the movie I watched.
What the fuck? What kind of fucking... You probably watched the J-drama. Did it start out...
It was a movie!
Okay, the question
is... It was a legit fucking movie, dude!
How did the movie end?
I think it ended with the first arc.
That's not how the movie ends. Okay, I'm assuming both of us here have seen...
Fucking pissed off.
He does have
I'm assuming
song.
Both of us here have seen the Death Note movie. Have both of us seen the Death Note movie?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the thing is it ends with Light sacrificing his girlfriend so that he can kill, what's his name's, fiance. So, I need to ask, is, are we going to have a genuine conversation, i.e., like, on Death Note and the movie, or are we just going to fuck around? Because believe me, I can fuck around if you want, but I came onto the podcast to discuss Death Note, or not discuss Death Note, but discuss this whole film, you know, the whole Bleach film thing.
Yeah, well, I don't know about the Bleach film. Can you, like, explain it to me? Because I'm just sitting here kind of just like, duh.
Okay, we'll be back.
Nope.
We are back alive.
Hello.
Hey, what is going on, everyone?
Get to the chopper.
Get to the chopper.
Get to the chopper.
No, it's not a tumor. It's not a tumor at all.
Damn it.
It's not a tumor.
Alright, so who wants to bring up the next topic?
I'll bring up the next topic. Yeah, you go for it. John.
Okay, it it's my topic.
Also, keep in mind, you've called me Nico multiple times on this podcast, so I have every right to call you John.
I said Zach.
You called me Nico, like, almost all the previous episodes you said, you're never gonna have Nico on the podcast?
It's confusing.
I think I'm just gonna call you Michael.
Michael?
Yeah.
Why?
I'll have to explain it afterwards. I don't want to make things bad.
Well, I'll explain it to you later as well, but I know someone, I'm related to someone whose name used to be Michael, so that's interesting.
Uh-oh.
Alright, so, Reaper, your topic, say now, before you lose traction on your podcast.
Alright, the way the order is, you guys, this is going to work. It would be me, Zach, and then ABO. So, my topic I want to bring up is Death Stranding, Hideo Kojima's supposedly new game.
Oh, yeah.
Now, of course, we all know Norman Reedus is in the game with his naked ass.
Yeah.
No, seriously, ABO, I don't know if you've seen it.
Like, have you seen Death Stranded?
No, I have not. I have not been on the gaming news for a while now.
Did you even see E3? Do you know what E3 is?
No. Are you fucking kidding me, dude? I know what E3 is. I just haven't watched it, dude. It's been a long time.
It's a fucked up thing, and including me, I believe it's part of Metal Gear.
But, told me about this. You told me about this.
Well, it starts off, and then, like, all of a sudden you see a foot and a leg, and then you see Norman Reedus' ass. And it's Norman Reedus, he stands up, and to where he almost shows a dick, and he doesn't.
Ass, sorry.
No, that's what we need to do. We need to mix it with that
Dude, watch that video.
I'll watch it after this.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And then, well, we all know Norman Reedus is in it, blah, 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 blah. Well, Kojima has been setting up shit. And he did a thing called Check. Posted a picture on there, checking whatever. And it's pretty much, I'll pull it up here as I'm talking. And it shows a back of a guy with a red jacket or whatever. And saying doing testing or checking or something like that. Oh, damn. Okay, getting off topic. but it shows that, you know, and he's in a camera rig for mapping or whatever. Well, all of a sudden, somebody pops up a picture of Mad Maquettes. Is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah, I think so.
With him and him, Mad Maquettes, which is everyone knows from Casino Royale.
Casino Royale, yeah.
Also,
keep in mind, we're talking about a lot of shit that I'm not even sure AVO would know.
Yeah. But,
you, I know what Casino Royale is. Fuck you.
Wait, you've seen... So you're into James Bond?
I've watched some James Bond films, just not all of them, huh?
I've got a whole collection.
Fuck you with assuming my gender.
here's the picture I'm sending you guys.
I've got a whole collection of James Bond films. I've got the entire Sean Connery collection. I've got almost all the Pierce Brosnan collection. I've got some of the other ones. Like, I'll have to find it. I'll send it to you guys later. I'll next time I come on the podcast, I'll talk about my James Bond collection.
But
James Bond film that to be The World Was Not Enough. This is my first James Bond film. It was good. Sorry, you can get back to your topic now.
Oh, it's my turn. Okay.
Yeah, no, get back to your topic.
No, you're not allowed to talk until everybody has said their piece, and then you have to spit your words in like 2 minutes.
There you go. But anyway, I sent you guys a picture of what Kojima pictured or put on Twitter. Now, this guy put this on Twitter and said 99% sure that man is Mads. And the fan base of Mad said he is right, that he's a part of Death Stranding.
Oh,
also,
wow.
Also, and check this picture out. This was actually recent at GamesCon. It's nice. A picture of Mads and Norman Reedus together. Appreciate it from GamesCon.
Look at that person in the background, like, praising the sun.
Yes!
They got their arms up in the sky, praise the sun!
Praise them!
I never noticed that. Why are they having their hands in the air?
I don't know.
There's a guy in the blue shirt. He's like, eh!
And dude, by the way, the second picture just looks like Scarce with the... looks like Ron.
Which one?
All right, the second picture that he sent kind of looks like if Scarce met Ron.
Jeez.
Oh, shit.
Hey, guys, it's Scarce here. Today I met Ron Corbin. It's pretty crazy stuff. I'm probably going to do a double post today. So we've got some pretty crazy topics.
God damn it, dude.
Hear that Stephen Meeks or Chrome Silencer got into an argument with Wacko Sacco.
Hey, can you stop? I hear Reaper screaming from you running him over. Can you back up, please? Like, I can hear him internally screaming. Like, go ahead. There you go.
Sorry.
You son of a bitch.
Did you burp? Was that a burp?
No, motherfucker.
That's the Reaper. That's the full Reaper.
That's my Reaper voice. Join me or die.
Reaper
420 in like 7 trillion years. and you hear that.
I think it'd probably be more digital. But anyways, Reaper, continue on with your topic, as okay. You were saying.
As I was saying, God damn it. Anyway.
Good topic.
As I was saying, everybody's pretty sure that he's in Death Stranding, which I think I'm sure he's in it. It looks like he's in it for sure.
Right. Which is cool. I'm interested to see where this goes. And I'm also really, really waiting on Silent Hills. And also another thing that is interesting that I saw is that Allison Road, the successor to PT, they shut it down. However, today what they did,
it's coming back.
Was that there? I don't know if it's coming back.
It's coming back.
What? They changed their profile picture on Facebook.
It's coming back.
It might be. Actually, they're hinting at it.
Zach, we were talking about this before you came back on.
What, Blair Witch or Allison Road?
Allison Road.
Is it back?
Yeah. He said he's doing it. He said he's doing it separately from the studio that he's working with. So he's going to do it by himself, is what he said.
Nice, dude. It's back.
So
I saw that earlier. I saw that they changed the profile picture, and I was like, "Where's this going?" And then apparently I missed it. But fucking hell, they he's back.
5, 6, 7, 6, 10. All right, cool. I'm just tally marking how many times you've hit him.
Dude, what?
Wait, what? This is my.
How much
this,
he ran you
this
over?
Is my topic now.
Yeah, that's his.
Oh, it's his topic. Topic now. All right.
Yeah. He literally changed topics.
I am sorry. I have not been keeping track then.
But okay. Anyway, yeah, Nico. I was reading about this before you came on that. I just watched a video that he pretty much said that it was by himself and that he's working it separately from the studio he's with now. Let me see if I can pull that back up. I mean,
stop. It says, if you read what they posted, they said, "Hi all, after a long consideration between Team 17 and ourselves, we have reached a mutual agreement to end our collaboration on publishing Allison Road under Team 7's game label." I didn't notice that. He never said we're done with the project.
Yeah, it just says, "Creator Christian confirmed that he would continue to work on the game on his own part from former studio Lilith."
He did a post on Facebook 4 hours ago saying, "We're back. It's been a little while." Einstein once famously said, "Failure is success in progress." As any of you who ever tried something new or different know, things don't always go according to plan. The path to destination is sometimes littered with hardships and obstacles. Being a bit overdramatic here, but I'd like to think that if you are really passionate about something and you are going to believe in its potential, you owe it to yourself to keep going. You learn from things to have happened, gain valuable experience, and bit by bit you move forward." But yeah, he goes on and says, "There are a few who've literally been following the game since day one. A lot have joined somewhere along the way, and quite a few kept getting in touch and asking how things are going, etc. Even after the cancellation, amazing, really. I'm quite glad that we're making this occasionally quite exciting journey together." So yeah, definitely a heartfelt thank you for that. "Moving forward here, I just want you to know that I do plan to post more updates in the past. However, they have been quite selective, as you can imagine, as I don't want to spoil things. One thing I also plan to do, which is always quite enjoyed, is to post more workflow stuff. So be prepared." And then he says, and lastly, hand on heart, I'll try to answer answer social media posts and more regularly. Seriously, thank you very much for sticking around with AR for so long. Let's do this.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I'm really excited to see where this goes, because PT had so much potential. I think that could even be its freaking what is it? That was its acronym, potential.
But you do realize it was downgraded. It's the Fox engine, but it was downgraded.
Right. But I'm still very interested to see where this goes, because regardless if it's a Silent Hill property or it's its own thing, I still love the atmosphere.
Oh yeah,
It didn't even feel. It didn't even feel like. It almost felt something completely different. You know what I mean?
Like Metal Gear.
We're in another almost type of Silent Hill, a new genre, a new
dimension.
Passing the torch. Yeah. I guess the next generation of Silent Hill, because the previous Silent Hill game to this was absolutely terrible. And also, what is the other one? Homecoming is also terrible as well. I played that one, and it's not good.
Trigger.
It was one of the only games that I've ever given back to GameStop.
But I'm honestly...
I got $14 back from it, because literally it wasn't worth my $14.
The one thing I want to know is if he's going to use the same assets, or is he going to rebuild it from the ground up? That's what I want to know.
Yeah. I don't know if you were one of those who shared that whole copy-paste, creepypasta-esque news article when it was going around, but did you see the reason that PT was canceled? It was the copypasta for that?
And we'll be back!
Oh.
Everybody listen to this.
No one cares.
But anyway,
okay, so
if you guys
John, explain the Bleach movie.
The Bleach movie?
Yes, explain that to AVO.
The Bleach
yes,
movie
please.
Is gonna be you've seen Bleach, of course.
What?
Have you seen Bleach?
I didn't hear you. Yeah, I've seen Bleach, yeah.
Okay. It's going to be based on the manga. It's going to be released in 2018. And if you've seen Bleach, you'll pretty much know what damn film is about. That's it. And it's going to be produced by Warner Brothers.
Okay, see, you didn't tell me that. Now I definitely do have some hope for this series.
With no
the thing
word,
about the Attack on
I
Titan,
don't
the
I
Attack,
don't know, dude.
The Attack on Titan movie, the problem with that is that wasn't done by Warner Brothers. This one here, the Death Note series, and I guess this new Bleach movie is also done by Warner Brothers. So I've actually got hope for this now.
Wait, Death Note series? The one
yes.
for Netflix?
No. The movie series. Death Note
oh,
1
the
and Death Note
yeah.
the lot. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna find them.
Yeah, yeah. No. I understand what you're talking about. The yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, but
Let me find. I found a trailer for the movie. AVO. I want you to watch this trailer and tell me if this is the movie that you watched.
All right. I'll tell you after the podcast because
no, not after the podcast. Watch it right now.
But he has 15 minutes.
Anyway, listen.
We'll talk. Me and we'll talk. You watch this, and then come back.
It kind of seems unfair.
Okay,
just watch
got...
it. Seriously, I'm curious. It's, ADL, I'm curious.
Just watch the damn thing.
God damn it. I'm curious as to if that's the film you watched or not.
Anyway.
Anyways, like I was saying, though.
Chat log, the guy that I posted the picture on.
Yeah, is that who's going to be playing Ichigo?
Yeah, Satou for... I don't know. I don't want to screw it up. But
right, let's look up... it's going to be... It looks like it's going to be pretty good. I'm kind of interested to see now.
They're saying he's a good actor, so, I mean... Oh.
Oh, man. I'm definitely interested to see where this goes. You know what I mean? Because, like I said, if Taika Kubo is behind production, it'll be good.
They're not saying any names. That's the thing. They're not saying who's in it. Just Warner Brothers. It's going to be released in Japan only.
No, it'll probably be released up here in America as well. But yeah. I'm assuming, I don't know, like how are they going to put the manga into one movie?
I don't know. It says Kubo Sensei, who wrote,
right.
Who wrote and drew the manga, will take an active role in the movie's production. So it only not only be enjoyable for newcomers, but also satisfying a longtime fans.
Exactly. See, that's the thing that if they do it right, like they did in the Death Note case, it would be good. Because, you know, like I said, there are a lot of films like the Death Note movies, like those are good, and the reason is because, and they've actually done the Bakuman, there's a Bakuman movie that they did, and it's made by the same guys who did the Death Note series, and also that one was also in production with the guys who did the Death Note series.
Okay, it says
so, like I was saying, if they do it right, they could do it good. And now, right. I guess that segues into our next topic. ABO, was that the movie that you're talking about?
I think it might be. I think. It was a very fucking cluttered trailer, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah,
Christ. I mean, I could not... Like, it didn't show any particular shots. It just goes, this shot, that shot, this shot, that shot. Characters, there we go, there you go. That's the trailer, watch it.
Okay, hold on, I'll find the movie so you can watch it later on. I sent a link to John a little while back.
But the one that I watched was like, they were talking for about like an hour or so, and they went through a couple of parts, and then they skipped a couple of parts, and then like Kira was like in a mall or in the middle of town wearing a fucking overcoat with no shirt on, and he looked like he came out of a fucking sweat house.
No, that's not the one that...
With a fucking CG Ryuk.
Well, there was a CG Ryuk, but I'm seriously, I think you saw the J-drama, because the J-drama is fucking, that sounds exactly what it is.
It was a fucking movie, dude. It was literally a fucking movie. I don't understand what you think. I'm watching a fucking J-drama when it was literally
because
a minute
every
and 25
episode,
minutes.
Every,
an hour and 25 minutes.
Every episode of the J-drama is an hour and 25 minutes.
Oh my god, dude. You don't understand what the fuck I'm talking about. It went through the entire first arc.
But the thing about this one is they add stuff to this one. It literally ends with they change stuff and add it. It literally ends with what's his name? Manipulating the death of his girlfriend and what's his name? You know, like his fiance. I mentioned that earlier.
Yeah.
But yeah, hold on. Let me send you the link to the movie. Just skip into it. Just skip into it to see if that's it.
I don't want to. We're in the middle of a podcast.
I'm sorry. I need to get.
Can we talk about another topic, please? Shit. God damn.
Boobs.
Bruno Mars reference.
Sorry, I just... I don't know.
It feels like you're trying to kick me off every 2 seconds. It's like, go watch this. Go leave now. I want you to watch this. Tell me watch this is clip. It. Bye.
Clip, at least.
No! Not in the middle of the fucking podcast. Goddamn, dude.
Are you scared?
I am very irritated. I feel like I got like 5 pounds of sand in my pants right now.
What the fuck?
Because it's irritating when you have sand in your... Whatever. Whatever. Don't get my analogy. Just say whatever about it.
Whatever.
Boobs.
Boobs are nice. I do like boobs.
Yes. Okay, but I don't know. I think we've gone on enough of this topic, this whole live-action anime movie, because there are a lot of times you could fuck up, but if it's under the... Like I said, my last thoughts on this, if it's under the right production, if it's under the right... Like you said, Tite Kubo is going to have a role in this, in the production of the Bleach movie. If they do it right, then they can... Then that'll be a good film.
I think what would make a really good movie, I know you guys haven't watched it or anything because I asked you both, but I think a good anime movie that I could see being really good over here would probably be Durarara.
I'd say that, but also keep in mind, if they westernize it, they could fuck it up bad. That's one of the things
I said. Dude, it's not even really, the most Japanese thing that's in there is literally just a sushi shop. Which you could change into anything. That's literally it. Like, that's the only thing. The rest of it has to deal with gangs and the characters. It doesn't really have to deal with Japan as an entire, you know, premise around it. It doesn't have very much.
Also, keep in mind, they gotta take 4 seasons and many arcs and put it into a film or a film series.
No, but I know that they have cut down, but, like, here's the thing.
I think it would probably suffer from a Scott Pilgrim syndrome. Well, that's what I call it anyways. See, have any of you guys seen Scott Pilgrim versus the World?
Yeah.
You know I do. Go ahead and fucking continue.
Say what you're going to say. Sorry.
God damn, dude. You fucking ran me over like a fucking train. Anyways, I think it would do good as a movie because there's so many arcs, and there are arcs that were really, how would I say, not necessary for the story. Like, you could have cut out, like, some of the arcs that were in the anime, and it would still make sense, like, 3 seasons, like maybe, like, 3 seasons worth of show, like, episodes. Like, you can melt that down, and that would have ended up being pretty perfect. I mean, there's a lot of scenes in Durarara that I think adds intensity to it, but it adds unneeded intensity to it, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
Like, it just adds more tension, but it wasn't really needed to, but it just adds on to the experience. But if they made it into a movie, if they removed some of that tension scenes, like, where they're, like, being quiet and stuff...
I need to cut you off here. I'm sorry to cut you off, but, my computer is freaking the fuck out right now. Like... It's cutting in and out. I might actually fucking blue screen. So if I drop,
oh shit,
yeah, and like that. That's why that, like, you just start going. I'm like, oh shit.
Can I continue?
Yes, you can continue. But I just want to make that clear. If I drop, that's why, because my computer fucking blue screen.
Fucking attention grabber. I mean, nah. But the thing is, I just think that would be... I think Durarara would make for a good movie because there's... Literally, you can just add in a couple of scenes, just add in some different type of stuff, get rid of some of the tension scenes, and I think it would just, you know, make a pretty good movie. I mean, I would like to see it as a movie.
That's interesting. See, like, now let me get my... Can I get my thoughts out on it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so... I think that they could do it right, but also they could suffer from what I call Scott Pilgrim syndrome. Scott Pilgrim syndrome is where they take an entire, I'd say, you know, about 6 or 7 comic books worth of story and arcs, and then just bash them all together into one film where they get some things right and some things wrong, and they mix everything, and they just throw the entire series into a blender. Like, hey, remember this thing they did right in the comic, but they fucked up in the movie? Like, it's one of those things that it could end up like that, where the fans love it because it's just fucking eye candy, but an actual fan or someone with a mind will look at it and go, hey, wait a second, this is nothing like the comic, or this is nothing like the original source material.
Alright, now, here's the thing with the Rara, though, like, because you haven't watched it, I'm guessing you haven't watched it yet.
No.
But if you watch Durarara, you can see that they do arcs not by... They do it very differently. They don't do arcs by stories. They do it arcs by character. So it's just like, they do one arc per character, say each arc is about 3 episodes long. They could cut, you know, they could cut about each of those episodes into 1 episode per character, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then when they continue on like that, I think it would probably... I don't know. You could turn it into a movie, I just think personally, because... There's some of the character background that didn't need to be explained. Like, there's this one where this girl... Alright, so there's this one... It's not gonna... Like, alright, I can't say anything because it will spoil it. But, you know.
Yeah, spoiler.
Yeah. Yeah. I really do want you guys to watch Durarara.
I'll check it out sometime. Like, and there's a lot of fucking anime I need to watch.
Baka and Test is one of them. Yeah,
exactly.
Do you know what Baka and Test is, John? God damn it, fuck, sorry.
Reaper?
Shit. Reaper, yeah, Reaper, I said Reaper.
Reaper.
Reaper, Reaper.
I am Groot. No, I haven't seen that.
Groot. Oh, alright, Baka and Test is basically the one where it's just like, basically these kids are in school, and they have these little... Fucking... Damn it, dude. You just have to run me over like a fucking train every 2 minutes, don't you? Anyways. It's basically a story of, like, these kids, and each class is, like, divided into how good they do in school. Like, F class is obviously the worst, and A class is the best. And they like, class wars with these little avatars, and whoever wins against that battle gets that class's class equipment. And it just follows around class F that I just find fucking hilarious.
Alrighty, we'll be right back again.
Alright.
Alright, we gotta shut up now.
I really gotta go because on my jaw.
And we are back.
I love it. I'm talking, and then we're like, "And we're back." And I'm like, "Oh,
that's
hey guys,
nice. And we're back."
I wasn't saying anything about having to leave because my jaw is hurting really bad, but yeah. Anyways, like I was saying though, did you ever see that that copypasta that was going around when PT was canceled?
No.
It was gay. Okay? It was terrible. The reason I say that is because this was the entire plot of this, of the reason that PT was canceled. So pretty much, it's from one of the creators or one of the developers. Pretty much, he was developing... I'm laughing trying to say this. He was developing a Google Glass version of PT. In this scenario. And so apparently what ends up happening is the AI for the characters got so bad or so advanced, and it would harass him, or it would just haunt him at night even when he didn't have the Google Glass on, so much so that he had to cancel PT entirely. And in fact, the last line is, "I can still hear her voice from time to time." Google Glass. Who uses that?
It's cool.
Fuck Google Glass.
Exactly.
That's an outdated thing now.
Exactly. Well,
it's all about that Google LASIK now.
That is so stupid. Like that, I remember seeing that. I saw a bunch of people sharing it. Like, oh man, this is so scary. I can't believe this is the reason they canceled PT. And I'm like, this isn't the reason they canceled PT. The reason they canceled PT is because Hideo Kojima was fired or left Konami at that point. We can argue back and forth about this all day if he left or not, but. Regardless of the fact, you can't deny the fact that something did happen with Kojima at that time, starting the cancellation or triggering the cancellation or removal of PT.
Zach, you want my input on it?
Yeah.
Hideo never had the rights. He never
to PT.
He never had the rights. No, not even the PT. To Silent Hill. He never had the rights. The thing is...
That's what I was thinking. Like, who... Has he... He's more been into Metal Gear Solid. Has he ever worked on a Silent Hill?
No, he's never worked on any horror movie. He did that to show people what he could do.
And also, keep in mind, he was doing that with... I just forgot to mention that he was doing that with Del Toro. Guillermo Del Toro or something like that. Yeah.
But, you know, he never had the rights, and he said that's why he called it, you know, at the end. And Toro even said that he, you know, they had to dumb it down, and they had to put Silent Hills at the end because he didn't want anybody else to know what they were working on. So you know what that means? It wasn't a Silent Hill title to begin with.
It was just a fluke.
Yeah, no, not a fluke. It was a red herring. It was the, you know, because Hideo wanted to work on...
I'm going to say, I'm sorry, but I have to disagree with you. I don't think that they would do that. That's too irresponsible to say we're working on a specific title that hasn't been worked on since, like, 2012.
Well,
and then say... Oh, yeah, by the way, no, fuck you. We're not actually working on that. We're working on Metal Gear Solid.
But don't tech companies do that all the time, though?
Yeah, and Hideo actually did it with the Phantom Pain. He made a fucking fake-ass character in a fake studio, Moby Dick Studio, Joaquin Morgan, which, if you rearrange the numbers, it's Kojima, and put out a fucking thing called The Phantom Pain and said, that's a whole nother game. And everybody figured it out. That's Metal Gear. That's not Phantom Pain. That's Metal Gear. That's part of Metal Gear. And he came out and said, oh, you know, no, it's not Metal Gear. No. And then when asked if Project Ogre, which is what he was working on, was part of Metal... No, I'm getting tired of people saying it was Metal Gear Solid. He fucking came out and said, The Phantom Pain... is Metal Gear Solid. Moby Dick Studios is a fake studio. And Project Order is part of Metal Gear Solid. So yeah, he fucking done all of that shit. What makes anybody think that he could fucking do it again?
That's just fucking stupid, though. Like, I'm sorry, maybe coming from someone who's a Silent Hill fan and not as much a Metal Gear Solid fan, I feel it's kind of scummy.
Well, it's not... probably... Sorry, can I say something, or do you
yeah,
just...
Yeah, go ahead.
It's just like, if you want to work on something and you disguise it as another product, so that way you can work on it, but still have secrecy about it. So
it's like if I said that the Wacko Zacko podcast... you know, I'm working on the Wackazacka podcast, but in the end, oh, boom, it's actually the Baff podcast.
No. Here's the way you can think of it, though. Here's the way you can think of it. You have this amazing product everyone wants, right? Amazing product. Everybody wants it no matter what. Well, you have to put work into that, but say if something happens and your work gets leaked, then all your information is already out. But if you have it into other projects and calling it other games, then how can they connect that game with the product that you want, that everybody wants?
Also, that's where it becomes convoluted. And that we were sitting here contemplating whether or not they're doing this type of thing. I think that's the thing that always has frustrated me with PT and the more recent endeavors of Kojima and Konami, is that it's not concise. It's like, well, it could be this, it could be that. You got a whole blackboard over here with red string tape, and it's like connecting the dots, like we're conspiracy theorists. Like, in the end, it's like what game? When I sit down to play a video game or whatever, like, I think I should know what I'm getting myself into. I should say, is there a new Silent Hill coming out? If there's a new Silent Hill coming out, then all right. Is there a new Metal Gear Solid coming out? Then all right. Like, if you're not working on it, like, if you're working on it in the background and you don't want to tell anyone, then don't fucking mention it.
Well, what happens if somebody does bring it up? And then you're on the spot if somebody's interviewing you for, say, E3, and they go, are you working on a new Silent Hill game? And they're just stunned there. They would have to either say yes or no in that situation. And if they ignored it, people are going to ask more and more often.
Not to mention, when you say something...
Go ahead.
Sorry, you're saying?
Well, not to mention if, when Hideo was like, when it was like Metal Gear Solid 2, he said he was quitting and not doing another one. You know, he was actually getting death threats to do Metal Gear Solid 3, then 4, then 5, you know? And if you want to do a project without people bugging the fuck out of you, I would do the same thing. You know, like, if I was doing a Let's Play and people are bugging the fuck out of me, which they're not, which is sadly. But
do a fucking Let's Play, John.
But, if I do a Let's Play of Metal Gear, and I want to work on a Let's Play and get it all fucking done, then release it, and instead of people bugging me to fucking do it, you know, I would do that.
Reaper, I want you to fucking play No Man's Sky. Let's Play. Do it right now, you fucker.
I'd kill myself.
All But yeah, that's the thing that kind of frustrates me, is that it's not concise. I don't know, like, you know, I'm just going to sit back. That's one of the things. That's why I'm always usually silent or neutral when it comes to Konami, because it's like, it's just a question of what are they doing? It's like, are they doing this? Are they doing that? And then you're just like, frick it, I don't care. Just wait till the games come out.
I'm just imagining, we're doing all these conspiracy theories, but literally it's the same company that came up with Yu-Gi-Oh! Capsule Monsters for PlayStation 2. Oh, God.
Konami made this one really awesome GameCube game for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I'm holding it right here in my hand. It's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which is based on the 2005 game, and Konami made that, and it's freaking awesome.
Oh yeah, they had that for the Xbox as well.
Oh yeah, I played that.
Yeah, I remember playing that. It was kind of that game.
Shell,
I think,
shock.
I just... God damn it, dude. Your voice is so high-pitched, you just pierced my eardrums. God damn.
And I got a bald one. Slice and dice!
God damn it, dude. You need, a better pop filter or something. God damn.
Sorry, I was doing that on purpose.
It hurts. Anyways, go on, Reaper.
But anyway, if you guys haven't noticed, Konami actually changed presidents.
Oh, really?
In April 2015, they changed president. It's Hideki Hook, whatever his name is. But they changed that.
Right.
Come on.
5 minutes.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
But actually, let's continue this in another podcast, but I want to hear Evio's thing.
Yeah, go on with your
All right. I got two of them for you. Basically, I just have some recommendations for some anime for you guys to watch.
All right, I'm gonna get my Google out here so I can bookmark it.
Shut the fuck up. Let me talk. I only have 5 minutes. Basically, God damn it, fuck you. what I wanted to say is that you guys should probably watch Durarara I would say Baka and Test, Summoner Wars, and then I would end up watching Erased, ReZero, and if you could, I would probably recommend Trinity 7, just because it's a pretty good harem one, not gonna lie. Kind of gives me that DxD kind of feeling, you know. And the next one that I wanted to talk about before we run out of time is that in video games, I think there was one most frustrating part that pissed me off so much. Have any of you ever played Halo 3 ODST?
No.
If you ever have, there is this mission. It's literally the second mission in the game where you have to find a sniper rifle on top of a wire. But if you're in this game, you just walk around blindly because it just tells you to find an object or a clue. So I'm walking around in a circle for 3 hours, literally looking around, and then all I hear is beep, 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 and I look straight up, and there's a sniper rifle on a fucking power line.
Oh, God.
That's bad programming for you.
That's horrible. All right.
Yeah.
I've been replaying a bit of Halo 2, which is, it's actually a pretty good game.
I think Halo 3 ODST is an okay game. It was like, it's kind of like the transition between like Halo 3 and Halo Reach, I kind of think.
Yeah, that's fair.
It kind of gives you that feeling a little bit. Tries to ease you in a little bit, but people are just like, hey, Halo 3 ODST is shit. It's shit. Just like a transition.
I guess I'll go on to my topic. Is that okay?
Yeah, we got 2 minutes.
We got 2 minutes left, so I'll go on with my topic and end off. I guess I'll end it off here, but I'm going to be working on some more projects, discount content. We've just started that channel up. It's me, Ron, and Undead Achiha, or hashtag stay negative and Undead Achiha, and all of us, we're on this channel, and it's a lot of, it's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be very interesting. So if you guys are interested in seeing the content that we're going to be making, go check it out, because we're going to be making some stuff pretty soon. We're going to get a schedule out. Just one last thing I'm going to say before we end off is if any of the listeners are in the San Antonio area and are going to San Japan, I'm going to San Japan as well. I'm going to be going through all 3 days, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. I'll be there with my camera. I'll be filming. If you guys are interested in that, then by all means, come say hi to me. If anyone's listening.
Half a minute.
Yeah, I know. I guess that's it. But thank you, guys. Yeah, thank you, John. Or Reaper, sorry. Thank you, Reaper. It's always great to be on the podcast.
Buy my shirts. Thank you, Reaper.
Buy my shirts.
No, buy my shirts. I need money. I need shirts. I need shirts and money, and I need money for shirts. Give me money, shirts.
Give me money.
I will if you advertise my shirts and I make money off of them.
Give me sponsorship.
Money. Yeah, I'll sponsor you. Sponsor me.
Okay. Yeah. That way, nobody gets paid.
All right, guys. See ya.
See you guys.
Bye bye, boss.
Hey, boss. Give it a f.
Ha 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 ha